So now that I've got the pen back, we're going to wrap this up by talking about something we promised to talk about at the end of last class, which is mechanism design.
Cool.
Right? That seems reasonable, right?
So it's like mechanical engineering.
It is not like mechanical engineering, except in a very abstract and analogy sense.
Okay.
So what mechanism design is, it's kind of the art, the science, and the engineering, dare I say it, of creating games to elicit certain kind of behavior. So far what we've been talking about with all our solution concepts and all the things that we've been doing in game theory 1, 2, and 3 so far is we've talked about what happens when we play games. And, you know, at least stepping back a little bit, what we get when we play games is we get certain predictable behaviors. And those behaviors are natural. They're Nash equilibria, or maybe they're correlated equilibria, or maybe they're Coco whatever equilibria and other things we haven't talked about. But here what we want to do in mechanism design is we want to make a game instead of just play a game, but again, with the end goal of getting some specific behavior. Okay? Does that make sense?
It feels kind of like inverse reinforcement learning in that we're going from the behavior that we want to a game that would make that behavior, whereas in regular game theory, we go from the game to the behavior.
Okay, I like that. In fact, I like it so much, I will draw the arrow that way. So here, we have a behavior we want, and we're going to come up with a game that would actually lead to that behavior. I like that. And then once we've made a game, what will happen is we will get people to play that game, and then that will generate the right behavior.
Nice.
Okay, cool. So it's like a sort of cycle of life thing. Does it seem reasonable?
Yeah, it's not a cycle, though, but sure.
Now it's a cycle.
Yeah, but I don't think that arrow means anything.
It means it's the identity function.
Behaviors lead to behaviors.
Right.
Which lead to a game. Sure.
Okay. So there are lots of ways that we could talk about this, but I think for the purpose of this class, I think the most interesting way to kind of get across mechanism design is just to give a few examples. So I'm going to give 2 or maybe 3 examples and sort of work through what is sort of easy and hard about mechanism design and try to give you a feel for why this is actually important and how by making little sort of specific decisions, you can have a huge impact on the behavior that people have. And in fact, you know, you could argue that everything that happens in politics, the laws that we make, they're all about mechanism design. They're all about figuring out how to influence behavior. They're all about incentivizing particular behavior by people. So the big example that people talk about every 4 years when there's a presidential election and we're worried about, you know, the budget is one of the biggest sort of mechanism design things implemented in the last several hundred years, which is the mortgage deduction.
Right?
So if you buy a house and you take out a mortgage, you get a huge deduction. And why is that a good thing? Well, because it makes buying a house cheaper, so it actually encourages you to buy a house. And we think that's a good idea for a bunch of reasons, but it doesn't even really matter why we think it's a good idea. We have actually constructed something to encourage people to buy houses.
Okay.
So let's see if we can kind of do this in the small and kind of think about how you might go about thinking about how you would generate certain behavior in people. Okay?
Sure.
Good.